Hi guys, I made this helicopter type thing last night. Very simple. I had this propeller on a plastic tube already from a fan driven car or propeller driven car kit, and I just taped it to this bit of cardboard so that it went straight up in the air. But what I'm going to do tonight is make my own propeller assembly so we can make it all scratch built. I shall cut some bits off of this pop bottle for the propeller blades. I shall use, these are actually paper straws, I shall use them for the body. But rather than the rubber band going up inside, because they're a bit too narrow, I'll have a bit of wood at the top there, or cardboard or something, and at the bottom, and have it sticking out like a model aeroplane, fuselage and propeller assembly. This is just the body. I could use a bit of cardboard for that, I suppose. That bit, I might reuse that. I might just take that off there and use something like that. We'll see. Something like that. For the propeller assembly, for the bearing or tube, I've got these cotton buds. I was quite surprised to find them because most shops are now selling paper buds or card instead of the plastic tubes, but these are still the old-fashioned plastic tubes, because there's quite a thing at the moment about these getting into the environment and causing problems with our wildlife. So, same, I was surprised to find them, but they are still available. I'll need some straightened out bent paper clips. So that'll go in there, hook on one end, bend it over on the other end. In fact, we'll use another one of them for the shaft of the propeller. Or a cross piece of the propeller, and then glue the blades, or sticky tape the blades onto the sides so we can wind it up. That's the general idea. So that's the beginning of the plan. Might need that bit of card in a minute. Let's see if we can make up our propeller blade. This is one that I've bent for something else, so I'll try and straighten it out again. Well, in fact, I probably don't need that. Let's just cut it off. Right, we need a bit like that. The hook for the rubber band, and that to go up through a bit of tubing, something like that. Of beads on the end of that to reduce the friction. Okay. these nice little beads here are a bit bigger than I want to use, but the really nice little ones that I got in there, little glass ones, the hole in them's too small for the paperclip to go through, so I'm going to have to use these ones. Are actually my daughter's their wedding decorations. A couple little bits of hot glue in them, funny enough. Might have to shorten the video a bit here while I poke them out. Glue in there, or some sort of glue anyway. So then, right. So that's our bearing surface. Now another one of these. Make it as long as possible. To measure that because I want the centre point. So we'll put a hole through there and push that through. About 70, so center point will be 35. Bit of tape around there to hold it in place. Okay, sticky tape time. had to move the camera because I couldn't actually work where I needed to work. Okay, that's what we want. I've actually made a mess of that. I'm going to do that again. This is the second time I made a real mess of it the first time. Tape's not sticking. Right, this is the second attempt. I made a mess doing it the first time. Sticky tape is not sticking. I've never had sticky tape that bad before. Right, that took a couple of attempts to do that because the sticky tape I was using just wasn't sticking. I don't know what the problem was, but it was no good. I had to change sticky tape. Right. So, we need some of this. And cut it at a slight angle to get the right curve on the propeller. And if I use this pen, it'll all come off on my hand because it's the wrong type of pen. Very sharp knife will be best. That'll be easier. Here first. think these are a little bit too big, but we'll go with them. Right, we need to carefully split right, need to take them in place. That's our propeller. This is all a bit of a problem because the sticky tape I wanted to use just doesn't seem to be sticky enough. Whether it's old stock or something. Stiffen that up with some hot glue, I think. Put a layer all the way around. you're wondering where the wing goes, we actually slide it in between the two tubes. Cool down and see what happens. slip that in place. Okay, put the lights on in the right place.
Well, this has taken a lot longer than intended. You'll notice this is much smaller now. It just didn't have the power to rise up. I've also trimmed the propeller down quite a lot because it was too big and it was rotating far too slowly. So I've cut it down to make it go faster. And I've got a double layer of rubber bands, so it's a more powerful motor. summary before I destroy it. So the original design I had to change quite a bit. I've made the propeller smaller so it spins faster. I've got two lots of rubber bands on it, double the strength. And instead of cardboard, this is a strip cut from a styrofoam clip. And I had it up at the top end first. I've now moved it down to the bottom end, but it seems to fly more stably. Not a lot more, but a bit better. It is at least going up and hitting the ceiling. Sometimes. Blades come off the propeller. It's only sticky tape holding it on, but I'll call it a day there. It's working. There'll be links in the video description to Science Toy Maker's Eco Empirical Butterfly, I think he calls it. That's what I based this on. He uses plastic tubes, I'm using paper tubes. These seem to be heavier. In fact, everything about this seems to be heavier than the original design. Science Toy Maker.